learning, joy, teaching, and pleasure, helping on the remote teaching and learning process, bridging gap, happy learning.
Subject Maths, Standard 7, Chapter 14, Part 3, Topic Algebraic Formula, or we can say expansion of squares. We have already done in previous slides in part 2 how to find the expansion of a square minus b square. Here are given some questions how to factorize. First one, p square minus q square is given, then 4x square minus 25y square, y square minus 4, p square minus 125, and so on. The questions are given. We are going to solve this in this slide. First question, p square minus q square. First, we compare this question with the formula a square minus b square. We observe that here the value of a is p and the value of b is q. So, p square minus q square will be equal to p plus q, p minus q. In second question, 4x square minus 25y square is there. But we have to make 4 also square of 2. Because if we are not making 4 as a square of 2, we cannot write 2x whole square. It's necessary to write this question in the form of a square minus b square. We know that 25 is a square of 5, so we can write 5 by whole square. Now when we compare this with a square minus b square, we observe that a is 2x and b is 5y. So we can write 2x whole square minus 5y whole square equal to 2x plus 5y, 2x minus 5y. Now next question, y square minus 4. 4 can be written as square of 2. Here the value of a is y and b is what? 2. Therefore, y square minus 2 square equal to y plus 2, y minus 2. Using this expansion formula which is given below. Same way, we will solve for p square minus 225. First, make 225 as square of 15. Then, we can apply the formula a square minus b square equal to a plus b, a minus b. Here, a value is p and b value is 15. So, we will substitute. Same way, we will solve for another question, 9x square minus 196y square. You have to check that number is this number is a square of any given number. So, if we know that 9 is a square of 3, we can write it as 3x whole square. Then check 196. Can we write this 196 as a square of 14? If possible, then write it as a square. Then we can write 14y whole square in bracket. Then apply the formula a square minus b square. We will get a plus b, a minus b. That is 3x plus 14y, 3x minus 14y. Now next question, a square b minus ab. In this you can see that it is not in the form of a square minus b square. Neither we are able to make it in the form of a square minus. So, in this type of question, how to factorize? First, see the common terms in both. We observe that in both we are having a as a common term. Take out a common, write the remaining terms in the bracket. We will get ab minus b. Now, again we see that b is coming common. Take out b common. We get ab, a minus 1. So, the factors of a square b minus ab is what? Ab, a minus 1. Now this another different type of question, 4x square y minus 6x square. In this you can observe that the factors of 4 is what? 2 into 2. Factor of 6 is what? 2 into 3. In both the case, you can see that 2 is coming common. Yes. Then you observe that x square is here also and here also. Take out the x square also common. So what is remaining in the bracket? 2y minus 3. Now in this question, 9th question, it is 12y square minus 8z square. Now in this, it is looking like 8z2, but it is not 8z2, it is z square. 12y² - 8z². Now you have to see that what is coming common in this. When we observe that, we find that this is not 12, it is 1 by, this is not 12, it is 1 by 2. We can write 1 by 2 y square minus 2 into 8 upon 2 z square. This is why we have written 2 by 2, because if I know that here 2 is in the denominator but 2 was not here in the denominator, so we multiply above and below by 2. So we get 1 by 2 common. What is remaining in the bracket? Y square minus 16 z square. We know that 16 is square of 4. So we can write y square minus 4z whole square. Now this becomes equal to the formula a square minus b square. We will apply that. So we will get a minus b and a plus b. It will be equal to half y plus 4z and y minus 4z plus 4z and 5 minus 4z. Now next question, 2x square minus 8y square. In this we can observe that 2 is coming common because 4 2 is 8, 2 into x square. So we get 2 common. We get to x square minus 4y square in the bracket. We can write 4 as square of 2. So we can write 2y whole square here. This again is in the form of a square minus b square. Once we get in this form, we can apply the expansion formula a plus b, a minus b. So it will be equal to 2x plus 2y, x minus 2y. Remaining sums of this exercise you will do as a homework and practice these sums also. Do this in the notebook and practice it. Have a nice day. Go through the link of the textbook given below. Thank you.